first shechita that we did for the Mesorah dinner was the elk shechita up in Hudson, New York. And it was quite a tense time because when we walked in there, there were only three elk available. And the first one was not kosher. And we usually, it was so not kosher, usually the whole lot has a chance of also not being kosher. And when the shochet went and the bodek went in the second time for the second animal to put his hand in, you could feel the tension in the air as we he came out and his facial expressions didn't, and he picks up at his head and says, Chalak, it's pure. And there was this huge sigh. Another challenge we had at the time of the elk shechita is that you need to do kisui adam. The problem was that it had rained, and we couldn't find any dirt. It was all mud, and we couldn't find any dirt around. So it was interesting. We kept digging and digging, but finally we found a tractor. In this scooper was some dried up dirt that was facing upside down, and the rain hadn't hit. It was very funny how, oh, look, we have real dirt. So we started chopping away on top, until the earth fell on top of us, and we collected it in a little bucket, and that's what we used for kisui adam. The thing of the elk was that since it's a chaya, we can theoretically take from the acharayim, from the back part of the animal, as long as somebody knows how to take out the gir hanasha. Well, we were lucky to have Reb Yedidya Hayon as our shochet and bodek, who does know how to take out the gir hanasha. And since it's a chaya and there's no chaylev, we were able to have and be able to serve at this dinner for the first time the filet mignon.
You'll see this is where the vertebrae, is that how you say the chedron, right?
Yeah.
See how the spine branches off into three branches. Here they are. One, two, and three. Here they are. See it? See them how they are?
Mm-hmm.
This is, if you really need the meat, you would end up cleaning this very well, but it's not worth it. So we just take off the, here, see that? I just took off one.
That's the gir hanasha.
Here's two, and here's the three, the third one. Here they are, and this is Shalom Al Yisrael, as we say. This gets cut off, so we don't have to bother back.
That we did were the birds, the fowl. That was quite a task. We did not anticipate how long it would take us. There were 250 of one kind, 280 of another kind. We had 50 geese. We only had six turkey. The six turkey,
so
actually,
200 people to go catch these wild turkeys, these six wild turkeys. The person that got us all these birds traveled all over the states to try to find them in his car. He went as far as Pennsylvania, Indiana, Ohio, all over the place to try to get our long list of these special birds that we're going to serve for the dinner.
The place was literally a zoo. Some of the birds were jumping out and they escaped, and we were chasing them around.
The smaller birds were harder because after you do the shechita, you need to check that you sever the kana and the veshet, the trachea and the esophagus. And that is much harder in the very small birds. So while the shechita took a half a second, it took a long time to make sure that the shechita was done correctly and that the right simanim, the kana and the veshet were shechted well. Da 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 The bird shechita itself took very, very long. We started about 7:30 at night, and then finally by 9 a.m., we had finished the actual shechitas, and some of the soak and salting to kasher at the melicha, hadacha, and melicha, but we clearly couldn't finish it, and we had to take all of the carcasses and find somewhere else to finish the melicha and hadacha. One of the items on the menu is goat. Goat was also very hard to get hold of. So we went ahead and we looked around. We finally got hold of 4 goats. Now, with 4 goats, you would think there shouldn't be too many issues. Well, guess what? 3 of the 4 were not kosher. So we were left with 1 goat, and don't forget, that's only half of the goat, because the back part, the hind quarters, we don't use. So out of all 4 goats, and a lot of money spent, we only ended up with a half a goat. One of the things that were harder than I thought or to get were the kachal, that's the udder of the cow, which the Gemara says tastes like basar b'chalav. You would think with so many cow shechitas in America and so many, you know, steaks what we have, that there would be, but no one seemed to be doing milk cows. It was a very, very big challenge. I was working with someone in Mexico for a long time to get us. We found a dairy, a frum, religious dairy farmer in Florida. We thought he can get us. We went all over the place trying to find it. And by the way, this really talks about what we've been doing for the last half a year, trying to find locations for all of these unique animals and birds. Well, finally, we got a break, and we found someone in Baltimore who said that possibly you can get us these cows. I went to Baltimore. In order for us to transfer it back to Chicago, it was challenging because it was over 90 degrees at the time in Baltimore. And I didn't have a flight until later that night. I was going to try to go standby. So I went to the store. I bought a cooler, filled it up with ice, and put in one udder. Then I squeezed in a second udder. They're quite large. Clearly needed another cooler. So this time I thought, you know what, I'll get away with the styrofoam cooler. I bought a styrofoam cooler, filled that up with ice, put in the udder, sealed it, went to the airport, thankfully got an earlier flight and checked it in. Suddenly I hear in the airport, Mr. Fishbane, please come here. That if I was covering my mouth, but I said, Mr. Fishbane, please come here. I come up to the United representative. Yes, what's the problem? Well, your package underneath cracked open. It seems that when the styrofoam went down on an angle, it hit the bottom, cracked open, all of the ice went all over the place, and they're looking at this very strange thing. Which basically was an udder, and they were quite nervous. Thankfully, what was going on. When it came back, when it landed in Chicago, there still was some ice on it, and it still remained cold, and talked it over with Carlos. We showed it to him, that's Chef Carlos Michalas, and thankfully it was still, the temperature was still good, and therefore we were able to serve it. Now the difficulty with udders is trying to get out the milk and to kosher it, and that there's a lot of halachos talked about, and thankfully Rabbi Goldstein, Rabbi Yisrael Goldstein, was able to squeeze out the udder the halachic way, and we're able to have this unique dish. The yak shechita was on one hand our easiest because three out of three were kosher, but on the other hand, they had significant challenges. The problem was that it's not the yak season now. So the yaks that were available were young. And when they sent it over to a plant in Hastings, Nebraska, we didn't have the facility to shecht such young yaks. What happens over there is there's a box. The animal, usually big steer, is going to the box. The box turns over, shechita munachas, like in the times of the Gemara. They do the shechita, they let out the animal, and then they dress it down. Over here, if the yaks were so young, they couldn't fit it, they were too little for the box, and they're vildachayas, literally, wild animals. And if you don't hold them securely, as we all know in shechita, if the neck moves or they're thrashing around, then the shechita is invalid, it's pasul, it's a nevela. So I have to tell you, it almost and didn't happen. Thanks to someone by the name of Fischl Ziegelheim, who's the owner of the plant, a very, very fine yid from Williamsburg. He came in and made things happen, moved things around, and before we knew it, all of the yaks were shechted, and it was a lot of challenges in taking the yak and sending it down the line to be dehyed, to be opened, to be looked at, because this place is used to steers, not the small animals. Every step of the way was another challenge to get it up, to hook it up on the hooks. By the time it got to the Bodek Pnim, he stuck his hands in, the cut, and all three, he said, were beautiful, beautiful reyes. There wasn't anything, any circus, any adhesions on the reyes whatsoever, and it was glatt beis Yosef. All the employees were intrigued by what was going on, standing by, trying to help out. They were extremely helpful there. And thankfully, all three yaks were kosher, and hence we're going to enjoy our yak steak tonight. There were many other things we wanted to get, for example, a giraffe. We were looking closely, we would definitely be a first to serve giraffe, but we looked at the price for two of them. We were able to get it for a very good price of $70,000. So we certainly could not afford that, and therefore maybe for the next time around we'll be able to serve giraffe and enjoy that.
It's gonna be a big challenge because you know all these different foods and I got some experience on it, but not kosher, you know. So this time it's a big challenge for me, and hopefully we're gonna make it work. From wild turkey goats, elk, deer, all that. And all those birds, you know, partridge, the squab, they're very creamy. So for us, it's gonna be a big challenge to, you know, to get the right spices on. Well, I never cook with the elk and yak. Those are my two challenges this time.